Whoa. Whoa, hello everybody. Okay, I think we should start, right? I see people joining us from everywhere. We are live on Instagram and we are also live on Zoom. We've got like 2 minutes, so let us allow people log in and we'll just get this party started. So, so 7 p.m. will start, so just hold on, you're on the front seat already, so just enjoy the song by Usher. Aben, I see you. Hello, Aben, what's up, man? I can see Moses Abba, my man. Ah, Hamidat is here. Hi, Hamidat. And I've got Hanks is also here. Good to see everyone. We get stuck, right? Okay. Time to ride. Good evening, everyone. Oh boy. If you're joining us live on Instagram, it's good to have you. Welcome on board. Good evening. And if you're joining us on Zoom, I can see lots of people on Zoom already. Wow, wow. It's going to be a big night. Welcome on board. Welcome, everybody. The only problem tonight is those of us on Instagram might not be able to see my slides, but not to worry, I will still talk and you'll get to hear, but those on Zoom will be able to see my slides. So either ways, we're all good. If you're ready, I am ready. So let's fly. I hope you can see my slide. Those of us who are on Zoom, can you see my slide? Can you see my slide? If you can see my slide, why don't you just drop me a message or something? Let me know you can see my slide. And then we flow. All right, if you're just joining me and getting to meet me for the first time, my name is Stanley Innocent, corporate workplace trainer, speaker, and author. I am the lead executive trainer at Bernie Tools Professional Trainers Africa. And of course, I run my speaking platform, Stanley Speaks Global Platform. And so if you're meeting me for the first time, yeah, it's great to have you join me today. I'm so excited. It's going to be a big night. Well, of course, you know that you are using your data to watch this, all right? Okay, I'm looking at this screen. I'm looking at this camera at the same time. I'm looking at Zoom and Instagram, so my eyes just going this way. So funny. What I'm saying is I understand that you are using your data to watch this, to stream this live. And so I'm going to be very meticulous with your time and your data. I wouldn't stay here for 10 hours or 1 hour or 30 minutes. I will try as much as possible to make this session very brief. Okay, maybe just, let's say, 10 to 15 minutes or thereabout. Give you the little nuggets you should know that would help you as you work either in the corporate workplace or the business place. So welcome on board. Thank you everybody for joining. Like I said, we've got people who signed up on Zoom and people who are watching live on Instagram. So good to have you join me tonight. Okay, like I said, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, we're done. I can't serve you all of the stuff that I prepared tonight. So what we will do is just follow me on Instagram or on Twitter at StanleySpeaks87, and then we can carry on from there, either through a one-on-one meeting or a virtual meeting. I think that will be best for everyone. So if you're ready like I'm ready, it's showtime, right? It's showtime, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, we are talking about a very simple subject matter. We're talking about, I hate my job, but I love the pay. Some other persons were like, okay, what if I love my job and I love the pay? Is this meeting for me? Someone said, what if I hate my job? I love the pay. Is this meeting for me? Now, let me break it down. Whether you hate your job and hate the pay, or you hate your job and love the pay, or you love your job, love the pay, love the job, hate the pay, whatever category you belong, this meeting is for you. And so, whether you're already working, all right, you're working in a corporate environment, or you're working in the business place, marketplace, or you are still at home, you don't have a job yet, but you're hoping to get a job pretty soon, this is your meeting. So in the next 5 minutes, in the next 10 minutes, I will try to maximize your time and give you little bits of stuff that would help you to be more productive at the workplace. Okay, let's fly. Now, three questions for you. As an adult, when you run into people, maybe an old boy from your school, someone you just haven't met for a long while, and you happen just to bump into him, or you're meeting someone for the very first time, there are three questions they kind of want to ask you. Three cardinal questions. It's either they ask one of the three, or they ask everything. The first one they want to ask is, who are you? If you're meeting people for the first time, they'll be like, who are you? All right, who are you? Excuse me, sorry, let me just admit some people in Zoom. Okay. Sorry. They want to ask, who are you? When you meet people for the first time, or you bump into someone you've never seen before, you've never met before, you've not worked with before, the question they want to ask is, who are you? Now, who are you? Who are you? That's the question tonight. Who are you? People kind of say, my name is Stanley, or my name is Jessica, but is that who you really are? Who are you is one question people get to ask you when they run into you. The second question is, are you married? What's your business if I'm married or not? What's your concern if I got a husband or if I got a wife? And the third question they want to ask you is, what do you do for a living? Where do you work? Okay, so these are three questions people tend to ask us, and it's like NEPA, those of you Nigerians understand what I'm saying. It's like NEPA will just off light from your head when they ask you, who are you? For just seconds, you begin to wonder, who am I? Am I Thanos? Or am I an American? Am I a Briton or something? Who are you? Second question, are you married? When they look at your fingers, they want to see if you have a wedding ring or not. And the third question is, where do you work? All right. Where do you work? Where are you working right now? That's the question I'm asking. For most persons, they are working on their dream jobs. Most people are fortunate to work on their dream jobs, okay? Most other persons just pick up jobs because what they were looking for was not presented to them. Let me say this to you very quickly. There are five things that affect where we work. Whether you are in the corporate work environment or you are in the business place, there are five things that influence where we work. The first one is education. Forget all of these guys that, look at people who have dropped out from school and they be like, this one have dropped out of school now, but he's still a billionaire, he's still a millionaire, he's got money, his life is still rolling. Do I have to go to school to make all the money? Do I have to go to school to have all of the reward, to have all of the relevance and recognition? Let me shock you. As long as you are in Nigeria, education still plays a vital role in the kind of job you will get. Yeah. Education plays a vital role in the kind of job you would assess. Okay? So if you're in school right now, please don't drop out. It doesn't matter if COVID-19 have driven everybody out of school. Ensure you're in school. Study very hard. Don't say third class, whatever, second class, lower. Please read. If your head has to remove smoke, let it remove smoke. Ensure you have all of them good grades, because it affects the opportunities you assess outside of school. The second thing that influences where you work is the demand of your skill. The demand of your skill. For instance, if I am a singer and I'm taking singing as a career, what if nobody wants to hear me sing? What if nobody in that environment or in that locality or in that region bothers about people singing? It means that you're going to be out of work. Let's take Yola, for instance, and I'm not bashing at anybody. I'm not lashing at anybody. We've got lots of artists in Yola, whether people who are singers or people who are painters, people who draw. The thing is, do we have people requesting for your skill? Are there people who want the service that you bring on the table? So before choosing any job, always know that your skill plays a vital role. In other words, if I'm going to get a skill, it should be a skill that should be regarded as a hot cake. Number two, the third thing that influences your career choice or your career path is your location. Oh, Benny, why do you think people like running to Lagos or to Port Harcourt or to Abuja or to Dubai? Those of us who are in Yola, why do you think we want to run away from Yola to other big cities? Locality, location. Your location influences your, you know, your ability to get a job. Yeah, right. Because if you are in a location where there are lots of opportunities, it is easy for you to assess job opportunities. In places like, okay, in a place like Yola, sorry, I'm bashing Yola tonight too, because it is Yola to the world, yeah? In a place like Yola, where you have limited industries, you don't have lots of companies around, it means that we have lots of graduates, we have lots of skilled people searching for limited jobs. So your location influences what career path you will choose. And the other one is relationship, your relationship. Your relationship affects where you work. When I'm talking about relationship, someone is thinking about, is he my boyfriend or my girlfriend? When you calm down, I'm not talking about your boyfriend or your girlfriend. I'm talking about relationship in that maybe you know who owns the company. You know who owns the business. You know who is the HR personnel. You know who is shortlisting people for work and all that. You know who is advertising. So because I know someone who knows someone who knows someone, it is easy for me to get a job. So in Nigeria, that factor still plays. So you can have your BSc, you can have your BTech, you can have all of the certificates, but yet you begin to wonder, why is nobody calling me for a job? Why is nobody interviewing me? Why is nobody demanding my skill? That is because you've got no relationship. So what I will say very quickly is this. In adding to your certificates, in adding to your BTech, in your BSc, and in, and all the skills that you have, establish relationship with people. And then finally, where you work, right? What affects or what influences where you work or your career path is economic realities. Present-day economic realities. Present-day economic realities. What this means is, it doesn't matter if you have the right relationship, if you have the right academic degree, if you're on the right location and you've got the right skill, if your economy in that region is low, is dead, it's down, it affects you. What I'm talking about is this. Just take, for instance, someone who is an engineer. You're done with engineering in school and you want to be a civil engineer, you want to be a chemical engineer. You're looking for an engineering firm to work and there is no job opportunity anywhere for you. Where do you think you're going to end up? Let me tell you something. Do you know these days we have people who read IRS in school as bank managers? Oh my God. We have people who read CRS, you know, running for president. I'm not saying that's wrong, but it means that our economic realities have affected how we do the things that we do, the career paths that we choose and all of that. And so you can find other people who read beautiful courses in school. When they are done with school, they are in the labor market, but nobody's hiring them. So because nobody's hiring them, they tend to end up in whatever kind of job. I want to ask you a question. Where you are working, you know, your place of work right now, your career path, where you are doing the things that you're doing every morning, is that your choice? When you were little, where did you say you wanted to work when you grew up? Oh, when I'm 20, when I'm 30, I'm going to work somewhere. I want to be an engineer or a pilot. The question is, do you find yourself in that career path? Truth be told, our current economic realities have affected the path that we have chosen for ourselves. Can I say something to you? Do you know that a lot of individuals today are dying on their jobs and they don't even know it? A lot of people are frustrated. A lot of persons are frustrated on their jobs. They don't find satisfaction. They are depressed, but they don't even realize that they are dying every day. People just get, you know, in our Nigerian setting, let's just talk Nigeria a bit. In our Nigerian setting, when you stay at home after graduating school for 5 years, for 6 years, for 7 years, no job, you begin to wonder, did somebody tie my destiny on top mango tree in the village? What happened to me? Are they pursuing me for the village? Why can't I get a job? And so when you stay home for 6 years, 5 years, 4 years, and 3 years, you know, after school and there's no job, there is a tendency for people to begin to pick whatever job they find. And so you find an engineer who doesn't mind to be a sales boy. I'm not saying that's bad or that's wrong. You find someone who read banking and finance, just want to be a hotel attendant or something. Well, our economic realities have affected us. And the thing is, a lot of people are dying on their jobs. They are not finding fulfillment. They are not finding satisfaction because of factors that I'm going to share with you right now. Okay, let's begin to wrap this up. Do you know that your work is your life? Yeah, do you know that your work is your life? What I'm saying is you spend a productive chunk of your everyday on your job. That means if you are in a place like Lagos, you wake up 4 a.m. in the morning or 3 a.m. in the morning or 5 a.m. in the morning because you want to beat traffic. And so you're on your job 7 a.m. and you work for 9 hours, or you're on your job 8 a.m. you work for 9 hours. This happens Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, every day. I'm saying to you, if you're going to work this way, spending a productive chunk of your life every day, every week, for 2 years, for 5 years, don't you think that that job should be worth it? A lot of people today have been carried away with the rewards that their job brings to them, the money, the paycheck. But do you know that there's a level you're going to get to where your paycheck doesn't matter anymore, where the reward you get from your job doesn't matter anymore? You hear people say, but you are earning 250K now, you are earning 100K now, why do you want to resign? Why do you want to quit? You should thank your God you have a job. They are just trying to tell you that there is something on their inside that knows that there's got to be better. There's got to be better than their present level. There's got to be better than what they are doing right now. Your job, your work takes your life. Okay? So if I'm going to be a teacher, if I say I'm going to settle to be a teacher, if I say I'm going to settle to be an artist, a poet, a TV broadcaster, it should be something I am passionate about. This question I want to ask is the first question I asked you when we started this broadcast. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Do you know that we have been configured for a specific work? That's my point tonight. Every one of us, we have been configured for a specific work. There is a specific assignment that we all as individuals have been cut out to do. And it is only on that job you will find satisfaction. It is only on that job that you will find fulfillment. Do you know that there is a difference between work and job? Ding, 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 ding. Yeah, yeah. There is a difference between work and your job. Your work is what you have been configured by life to do. Do I say that again? Your work is what you have been configured in life to do. And your job is what takes you there. Your job is the vehicle that takes you there. So in other words, I can lose my job, but I still have my work. You can fire me as a teacher, but I still have my work. My job is different from my work. I am not my job. I am my work. Okay? So what I'm saying to you is this. Think deep down, you know, in your head, in your mind, and in your heart. What work have you been cut out to do? What work have you been configured to do? If you do not find what that work is, it doesn't matter what job you find yourself in, whether they pay you $1 million or something, you will still not find satisfaction. Yes, you will still not find fulfillment on that job. So the question is, who are you? Who are you? Are you a pioneer? Are you a sustainer? Are you a driver or a stabilizer? I just mentioned 4 categories of people you always find in the workplace. 4 categories of people. People who are pioneers, people who are sustainers, people who are drivers, and people who are stabilizers. So you have to be one. You can't be everything. You can't work everywhere. You can't express your essence in every category. What I'm saying is this. There are some persons who are cut out to be employers of labor. There are persons who have been cut out to be entrepreneurs. There are persons who have been cut out to be employees. And so it's very ridiculous and wrong when we want everybody to become an entrepreneur. It's not possible. Not all of us are cut out to start up businesses, to start up organizations, to become CEOs, presidents, and founders. Not everybody is cut out for that. So we have people who are pioneers. So ask yourself, am I a pioneer? Am I somebody who breaks the ground? Am I someone who charts new courses for people? Ask yourself, am I a sustainer? Am I a driver or a stabilizer? In other words, I am helping people gain fulfillment in doing the things that they do. So what this means is, if I don't find what class I belong, if I am a pioneer and I find myself working as a sustainer or as a driver, then I'll be frustrated. Have you noticed that these days, a lot of people, because there are no jobs, everybody wants to start up a business. People are starting soap business, slippers business. Everybody on my WhatsApp status, they are all selling something. They are selling granite. They are selling clothes. They are selling shoes. I'm like, oh, goodness me. But the funny thing is that, check these businesses, 3 months later, it has crashed. 3 months is even too plenty, it's even too long, sir. 1 week later, they don't have the capacity to sustain the business. That is because you are not cut out to be an entrepreneur. So you need to ask yourself, what am I configured to do? That's the question we are doing today. What am I configured to do? You got to think, what am I configured to do? Am I configured? Am I wired to be an employer of labor, an employee, an entrepreneur, a pioneer, a sustainer, a driver? It is when you are on your work, what you have been configured to do, that's when you begin to find fulfillment. Now, am I saying that because you should be a pioneer, tomorrow go and start pioneering something, am I saying you should resign your job or quit? Oh no, my hand on the inside. All right, I'm not saying you should quit tomorrow because in your mind you know you're supposed to start up a business and all that. There is what is called process. Okay, so if I realize that I am a pioneer of something, if I realize that I am supposed to be a CEO, if I realize that I'm supposed to be doing a big things, breaking grounds and moving forward, there's what is called process. So there is nothing wrong with me starting up as an employee. Yeah? Helping someone stabilize. Helping someone drive his own vision. Helping someone drive his own work. While I am doing that for the person, I am getting I am getting a little bit of exposure. I'm getting a little bit of experience. I'm getting, you know, a little bit of my capacity developing as I work. So, what I'm saying next is, do not disabuse your process. You might be on a job that you don't like. You might be on a job that you don't want. For instance, because there is no job in the country, you ended up as a teacher, but your dream is to own a bank. Your dream is to work in a bank, or you want to work for a consulting firm like KPMG and all of those kind of stuff. But right now, you find yourself as a classroom teacher. That doesn't mean you should start giving shitty attitude. Forgive my English. That doesn't mean you should start becoming annoying or a pain in the ass, frustrating your boss, frustrating your colleague. See, let me tell you something. Some of these teachers you see in secondary school, you know, always flogging students. What they are just doing is pouring their anger and frustration on those children. Kilode, is it me that say you should pick up a job as a teacher? And so because they don't see themselves in a bank, or they don't see themselves in a consulting firm, you know, beating them up for all manner of reasons. Please don't kill someone's child. I'm just trying to joke. But really, a lot of people who are frustrated on their job, they always look for other persons to pour out their frustration on. But let me say this to you. If you are on any job today that is not your dream job, I'm rounding up now. I know your data wants to finish, so I'm rounding up now. If you are on any job, right, that is not your dream job, maybe you are a pioneer, but right now you find yourself as a sales boy or as a receptionist, that's not your dream job. You know deep within you that you deserve better. You are supposed to be better than where you are right now. What I'm going to say to you is this. See that phase as a process. See that job as a process. See that job as a base for you to develop capacity, to develop competence, to develop experience, and to gain exposure. All right. Some persons are fortunate and lucky enough, you know, to jump into the job of their dreams, while other persons have to go through process. So today I am a clerk in a bank. I get promoted. I become maybe a front desk agent or something. And in 2 months or in 2 years, they move me up to customer service. And I keep moving until destiny shines on me and I grow the capacity to actually own that bank. All right. So my message to you tonight is very simple. No matter where you work might not be your dream job, but commit to it. Those of us who are spiritual, someone said something. He says, whatever your hands find to do, do with all your heart, do with all your mind, do with all of your energy, your enthusiasm, everything that you have. Commit to a cause, because it is on our jobs that we find fulfillment. Oshé, I think I should stop here tonight, right? Before you start looking at your data, 10 MB remaining, 1 MB remaining. This guy has reached my MB. Let me stop here. Okay. But to wrap this up, to make sense out of what we talked about tonight, I said there are 5 key factors that affect the career path that we choose. There are 5, you know, determinants of the kind of jobs that we do. In summary, I said the first one is your education. Don't play with your education. If you're an African, please don't be acting like these are white guys. Their location is something else. Everything is possible. In Africa, here in Nigeria, we have a long way to go. So don't go and start telling your certificate. You will chop. Let me calm down. All right. Go to school. Get an academic degree. It gives you opportunity. All right. So go back to school and get your degree. It influences what you will do. Just imagine someone who wants to be a manager or something, and they're asking you, where's your paper? And you're looking at the ceiling, or you're very religious, you're praying and jiggy jiggy. Go and shake all the mountains in the world. I don't know what miracle you're looking for. So your education influences your career path. The second thing is your demand of the skill that you have. Have a skill that people want. I'm tired of seeing too many people rapping. Will rapping give you food in this life? Please, go get a skill that is in demand, all right? You can Google what's the demand of skill in the next 5 years. The world is becoming techy these days. So are you positioning your skills such that you can find job in your location? The third thing that influences, like I said, is your location. Your location gives you access to opportunities. So sometimes if you need to leave your location to greener pastures, don't let any inspire to Maguire people make you stay in the location. If you need to move. Aben is watching me now. Aben is in Liberia or something. Aben, you're no longer in Nigeria. Why did you run away? Why did you leave Yola? You left the country. Location. Now you have assessed better opportunities. The fourth one is relationship. All right. When you know who knows who knows who owns the firm, it's easy for you to get into the work environment. And finally, our economic realities. To wrap this up, no matter where you find yourself working, no matter what you do, just give your best. All right? Give your best. Whatever you've been configured to do, give your best. And finally, you know, speakers like us, we say finally 100 times. So this is the 99th one. So finally, walk with a sense of urgency. All right? Walk with a sense of urgency. If you need to start up a business, please start. If you need to go back to school, please go back to school. If you need to submit a proposal, stop saying I'll do it tomorrow, I will do it next week. Stop being comfortable with yourself. Now is the time to work. Time waits for no man. People are dying like fowls and chickens every day. Do you know that? Okay. The biggest tragedy of a man is to get to the end of his life only to discover that he never really lived. With this few points of mine, I hope I've been able to convince you and not to confuse you to give your best in everything you do. Thanks guys for hanging here with me. I promise to finish before 7:30 so that I can remain small data for you to call your sweetie and your honey. So let me remain your small data. Thank you very much for joining me tonight. I can see everybody from everywhere. Okay. I think we are done on Zoom. Zoom is about to log us out. So I'm being logged out on Zoom right now. But thanks, guys, for joining me on Instagram. I really appreciate this night. So thank you very much. Follow me on Instagram at StanleySpeaks87. On Twitter, I'm there. On Facebook, I'm there. And I think we can carry it up from there. I'll come your way again next week, Wednesday. Until then, thank you for joining me. Good night. Please leave me a review and leave me beautiful comments and leave your criticisms. I will appreciate it. I'm out of here. Thanks, guys. Good night. Alright, thanks guys. Javan, I can see you. I can see Miracle, Bodia, Josh Krell, Comfort, Aben, Bidom, Infinite Hot 8. You don't have a name. Good to see you, man. It's Stephanos, Hickson, Olusolite here, and everybody who's on Instagram. Thank you so much. My big brother is here. Mr. Kings, thank you so much. Shadea, Yor, Sam Wilson, Honey. Thank you, everybody. Good night. I love you. God bless you.